There's a channel whose content is so problematic and no one is talking about it. Big Brain Coup. And it's spearheaded by this man, Beer Biceps or Ranveer Alhabadia, whose content revolves around maximum shock value topics, which he himself has said he doesn't believe in 100%.
So, logo lagta hai ki main, mera kutta, meri puri team bhi nofap follow karti hai.
Kaun hai ye log? Kahan se aate hai ye?
So him and his content form company are just making such content to bait in those clicks while insulting the intelligence of the whole country. This is something I want to talk about today. Let's begin. Hi, my name's Pranav and you're watching Science is Dope. When I look at the content on Big Brain Co, what I see is a serious attempt to make things mentioned in the ancient Indian scriptures, particularly Hindu scriptures, seem scientific. And quite often what they say feels like a conspiracy theory. And here is why I call it that. This is what conspiracy theorists do. They take a statement, science is copying Hinduism, and turn it into a question. Is science copying Hinduism? I don't know. It sure is a possibility. And here is the key important thing they do. They never answer that question.
This is your final question. Are you ready for it?
Yes, sir.
Is science copying Hinduism? Option A, yes. Option B, no. Option C, I don't know. Or
option D, we have to consider the spiritual significance and the scientific resemblance of the 10 avatars of Vishnu and Darwin's theory of evolution.
That's exactly what they said in the video. Don't believe me? I'll leave that video link down in the description. Now, I understand if there's a child's understanding of clickbait, you say whatever you want in the title and thumbnail to get people to click. But these videos don't do only that. They acknowledge the criticisms against the idea they're discussing in the video, but they dismiss it as just something being said by these pessimistic naysayers and critics. For instance, they mentioned that there is this paper published in 1974 which criticized the Vaimanika Shastra, and that's it.
1974 mein bhi ek paper published kiya gaya tha which criticized the mention of Vimanas in Vaimanika Shastra.
They move on after that one sentence. Now, I've linked that exact paper down below so you can check it out. It's published by scientists from the IISc and it straight up debunks the Vaimanika Shastra. And they're here peddling it as legitimate science when it's been completely debunked. Let's take their evolutionist copied from Hinduism video. I've made a video debunking exactly this, talking about how this is just a case of seeing patterns where there are none and associating it with science to make it seem legitimate. And I made my video even before they made theirs. Now I'll give them the benefit of the doubt. They probably never watched my video given that I'm a tiny, not even 100k channel. But to actually make this video and honestly believe in it requires throwing common sense out the window. Or you can sacrifice your honesty and integrity and exploit your audience, which I'm gonna talk about later on in this video. Right now, I want to ask the question, why does this content work? Why do these videos end up getting hundreds of thousands of views? I mean, won't people see through all the nonsense in the video? And you know what my answer would be? This sort of content works only in India. And here's why. Here's a graph of India's per capita GDP from the year 1960 till today. It didn't cross $500 till the 2000s. And even though it has risen at a faster rate after that, it still only is at around $2,000, which isn't all that high. It's no secret that India is not a wealthy nation. Most of India is middle class. For decades, most families just want to improve their economic standing. And what's the best, most guaranteed way of doing that? High-paying jobs, and the most common of them are engineering and medicine jobs. And how do you get them? Get into top engineering and medical colleges. And how do you get in there? By getting good marks in school, especially in science. And so families would send their kids to school and pressurize them to get good marks. Now, I went to school in the 90s and this was my experience, and I'm sure most of you would have had a similar experience. If you disagree, hey, the comments are all yours. I would see that most of my classmates who were at the top of the class weren't really interested in science. They only wanted those marks that would get them into college. The students who scored well in science weren't doing it because they loved learning science. They only saw science as a means to an end, the end being more money. And the students who didn't score well obviously didn't care about science. Most teachers who teach science were probably also like this when they were in school. And when you have students and teachers who don't care about the science they're learning, here's what it sacrifices. Scientific temper. That's why pseudoscience is so mainstream in the country, because people don't understand how science works. All the pseudoscience just becomes more popular instead of being dismissed as a conspiracy theory like in most other parts of the world. On top of that, when you have people labeling things in religious scriptures as being scientific, this inability to tell when science is being misrepresented, along with people's communal pride, can lead to some ridiculous ideas that people believe in. And to exploit such people, we have channels like these making content like this to bait them for views. And this problem where the education system fails the students miserably exists in areas other than science. For example, my Hindi is so bad because I've never had a Hindi speaking circle growing up. English learning in most places also suffers for the same reason. If you want to learn a language well, you have to learn it from a native speaker. And this is where the sponsor of this video comes in, Cambly. Cambly is the only app in India that provides one-on-one private English classes with tutors from USA, UK, Canada, etc. Basically native speakers of the language. It is especially good for those who know how to read and write but struggle with speaking English confidently. You can choose from different courses like business English, IELTS, personality development, etc. Tutors on Cambly are friendly and supportive and will help you improve your weak areas without any judgment. Here's the interaction I had with one of their tutors. What areas of English do they have the most trouble with?
Past tense, always. I think even people who are aware of, they should be using verb 2 for the simple past. Even when they're aware of it.
Okay.
When they know it in theory, it's a different thing knowing it in theory and actually doing it in practice. So that's the beauty of when they come onto Cambly. Now they get the chance to practice it.
My users can get 22% off any 3-month plan by using the code 22pranav. Just click on the link in the description. And now back to the video. It's interesting to note that this is not the only type of content that Big Brain Co has. They also have so much variety content that I think they're just throwing random shit at the wall to see what sticks. According to their own channel introduction video, they're trying to build content targeted at millennials to help them with financial fitness and dating advice. But their big man upstairs is Ranveer Alhabadia, aka Beer Biceps, and you can see his influence on their content. Just like how he started with fitness and ended up at conspiracy theories, these guys are also starting with all this content and ending up with conspiracy theories. I'm not too surprised if your content has to be approved by someone who only cares about how many views the video can get. Even if it means sacrificing your own honesty and integrity, then this is what you end up with.
So, logo lagta hai ki main, mera kutta, meri puri team bhi nofap follow karti hai.
Kaun hai ye log? कहां से आते हैं?
I wish someone had asked him in that Q&A whether he believes in all the bullshit he peddles. I would have loved to hear the answer to that one. Actually, I don't think such a question would even make the final video. What Big Brain Co should understand is that there might be views and money and ad revenue in the short run, but in the long run, when the audience realizes they're being exploited, that not only destroys their trust, but it also destroys the channel's sponsorship opportunities also, because nobody wants to buy anything from someone they don't trust. India is a country that desperately needs rational thinking, because you have scammers like these that go on national television and promote their scam. Because there are thousands of people every year that have these sketchy medicines in the name of Ayurveda and end up getting liver injury and die because they can't get a liver transplant. because we have highly educated people who end up spending their entire life savings to change to a new house because an astrologer said their old one was bringing them bad luck. Because we have celebrities who will promote unscientific medicine to the masses, but when they get sick, they'll only take treatment from the best that scientific medicine has to offer.
Bollywood superstar Amitabh Bachchan, who's currently undergoing treatment for COVID-19 in Mumbai's hospital.
Because we have an entire ministry that not only safeguards, but does everything to promote unscientific medicine in the name of nationalistic pride. Big Brain Co. with their content is making this problem much worse. When you watch content like theirs or any other channel that peddles this kind of pseudoscience that lowers the IQ of anyone watching it, just remember that they're not the ones causing the problem. They're just like a surfer riding the wave created by it. The solution to all this is very long term. Just like how pseudoscience didn't come about overnight, it's not gonna disappear overnight either. It's a long fight where we realize that the government and the authorities aren't helping. Content creators like this aren't helping, and our education system isn't helping either. Let's try and take rational thinking into our own hands and fight ideas like these wherever we see them, online or offline. And let's build communities around this. That's what I'm trying to do. At least subscribe if you're new and check out my content if you just found it and you like science and rationality. If you like this video, then you might also like this one I did on another set of content creators who like peddling conspiracy theories. I'll see you in the next one. Till then, remember, science is dope.